course, of course. Today we are celebrating the 10th annual Hemp History Week, and I want to know, what is it about hemp that has drawn you and your company?
So, what has drawn me to hemp? Well, I got into the hemp industry we started District Herbs in 2016, but I would say we got into the hemp industry in 2017. And I'm a clinical herbalist and a massage therapist by trade. And District Herbs is co-founded by myself and Claudia Joyeco. She was actually my herbal instructor. I studied under her. And I really wanted to find a product that I could incorporate within my practice. And so we went into the pain direction.
Pain management?
Okay. Yeah. And once we realized how effective hemp could be for pain, it really was a natural fit for us. And so what we've done and what we believe in is utilizing hemp and plant medicine as all one thing. So in our balms, we combine hemp and CBD derived from hemp with other herbal ingredients. So one of those is kava, which is an excellent herb for anxiety relief, and that's when you'll drink it and take it internally. When you put it on topically and you rub it on your skin, it seeps into your muscles, sinks in very nicely, and produces a very relaxing effect. So it's excellent for pain and pain management. Hops is the other herb, which everyone's probably familiar with. Hops is
here. Hops,
right? Yes, hops is the only other herb in the cannabinoidae family, and it's kind of not really ironic. I think it's nice that the two cannabinoidae plants are both for relaxation and having a good time in life. And hops is very anti-inflammatory, and so they pair very, very well together. And then cranberry, which is an herb that does exactly what it says it does. It relieves cramping. So we really try to educate our customers on how to use medicinal herbs while they're taking in hemp. And we find that there's a lot of interest and a lot of excitement around hemp. And it is a nice jumping off point for learning about other medicinal plants. And I find that people who are really attracted to hemp, and especially to CBD, are often attracted to plant medicine in general. So.
Awesome. And now that we have the farm bill that passed at the end of the year, how important is it to have places such as Spicy Cloud Lounge where you can experience hemp freely? How important is that?
I mean, it's so crucial. It's crucial not only for the local community and for local industry, being able to support small businesses who are really doing the groundwork, which I think you have always been at just that ground floor level of building an industry from the ground up, like a grassroots hemp industry. And it's nice to be able to support small companies who are supporting the community, who care about the ingredients that they're putting out there for consumers, who care about the health of their customer. It's really important.
Yeah, and spaces like this are different because owners such as Tati are taking a huge leap, being ahead of the wave almost, and kind of seeing what is allowed as the rules are being made.
Yes.
So yeah, super, super cool to be a part of that. And then you mentioned the local aspect of your business. Why is that important to you?
It's important because I would hate to see the cannabis industry become just another multinational corporation-run industry. And I think I'm starting to see that. And I would hope that as we progress on this issue, that we really take into consideration the social justice aspect of it. And that is not only dealing with the incarceration rates, and the communities that have been devastated by prohibition, but also the economics and who is benefiting from the growing industry. And so when you're supporting local and you're supporting small businesses, you're really supporting people's like true livelihoods. And I think that is the most important aspect of legalization. And I hope small businesses such as ours are able to survive going forward.
Yeah, that's very important. And one other thing that I want to add in terms of being local, it minimizes the carbon footprint and the negative impact that we have on the environment and the planet as a whole. So, yeah, thank you for your stance and taking care and supporting local business as well as sourcing ingredients locally.
And thank you for providing a venue and a platform and just sticking with the cause.
Yeah, well, shout out to Tati Colina of Stacy Cloud. I remember we actually met back in 2014-2015. We were at the High Times Business Conference, and Tati had some beautiful hemp clothing. So I noticed that you were wearing hemp today.
Yes.
Can you tell everyone a little bit about hemp clothing in general and why it's a staple in our history?
Well, so I'm wearing a hemp-made jumpsuit. I actually purchased this at a night market in Thailand. And I didn't know it was hemp right away, but it immediately caught my attention. And I paid 1,000 Thai baht, which worked out to about $40 US, which I feel like for if this was in the US market, I would probably pay $200 for it. But I went on the company's website and realized they were working with hemp. And hemp clothing, I think, is going to be like the next major fashion trend. And I'm really excited.
You guys are listening to that? Hemp is the next major fashion trend.
Yeah, I can't wait to see what is coming in this regard. And when you can get organically grown hemp, you know, it uses so much less water than cotton. And I hope that with the more popularity, it will become a fabric that becomes more economically available. Because right now it's pretty expensive to get hemp-made clothing, but you know, it's very durable and long-lasting. And I love it. I mean, I knew you wear a lot of hemp, actually.
Yeah, every day.
Yeah, every day. Yeah. It's very comfortable and light and breathability. It's perfect for summer.
Perfect for summer and some of the other things, antimicrobial, so you can sweat in it and it's not gonna absorb bacteria in the same way that you would comparing it to cotton. So there's so many benefits. So we covered a little bit about your company with District Herbs. We talked a little bit about fabric. What do you think is the next wave for the hemp industry now that we have the farm bill? People are more hip and in tune. Businesses are more open to accepting it. The vaping game is about to change as well. What do you think the next place for hemp is?
Well, I think we still have some ironing out to do on the laws around hemp and CBD and what's legal and who can sell and, you know, just kind of getting those laws figured out, and hopefully it's done in a way that's equitable. I would like to see hemp, not just hemp clothing, but a resurgence of hemp made, using hemp as like fabric, and not just in terms of clothing, but like hemp furniture and hemp, just getting into hemp manufacturing, hempcrete, using hemp stocks to make concrete, more sustainable sources. So I think if we could get the environmental movement and hemp movement all together, that would make it really beautiful.
Yeah, that is super important. You just hit the nail on the head with that environment. So is there anything else that you wanted to add or tell the guests about?
I would say check us out on Happy Hemp History. check out District Herbs. We're at districtherbs.com. You can visit us at District Herbs on Instagram. And we hope to see you at Spacey Club.
Come and join us. We're here all night.